Pamiętajcie, że mamy tutaj pana w białej koszuli. Jeśli chcecie zadać jakieś pytanie, proszę się do nim ustawić. I don't know that there is a guy in a white shirt. If they want to ask you a question, you have to stand in line behind them.
Oh, perfect.
That's why we know how many people, and there are plenty of them. Actually, I want to ask you something. But before they do, which show cherish you more? Teen Wolf or The Walking Dead?
I cherish more?
Yes.
But both shows are very, very special and very, very unique. But it's been a pleasure to be on Teen Wolf all six seasons. And it's very dear to my heart. And our fandom is very dear to all of our hearts. So.
Yes, they are. And that's why everybody is so sad that you have to finish it. But do you like it on the show? You're happy how it's all resolved?
There are a lot of surprises. And it was bittersweet to have the last 10 episodes because there's, as our fandom knows, there's a lot that happens on our show in every episode. So to honor everybody's storyline was interesting and creative to have to do for the writers. So I'm just as excited as everybody is to see the last 10 episodes.
And I'm curious because I read in one of the interviews with creators that the parents in the whole show supposed to vanish in the first episode of the first season and we will not see them anymore?
Yes. So when I auditioned for Teen Wolf, there were many, hundreds of other mama calls that were going in. And I got the call and my manager said, listen, you're not the first pick, but, you know, Teen Wolf, very exciting, young audience, and don't worry about it if it's not a good fit. They only want you for 3 episodes. And so now, many, 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 many more later, it's just been a real honor to be on the show.
But is it true that you received this role because you were on the place, that they didn't have to fly you from anywhere?
Oh, I was in Los Angeles, but yes, I did live in Atlanta, and so I was very lucky to live and work in Atlanta for both Teen Wolf for 2 years and also The Walking Dead. The Walking Dead is shot about an hour south of Atlanta.
See, that's what I was asking Olga was because everything is shooting in Atlanta. I was surprised. Okay, there are plenty of you who want to ask the questions, so let's start. If you don't want to hear me, okay.
Hi, Lisa.
Hi.
Can I tell you Kocham Vas? It means I love you in Polish.
Oh, that's beautiful. I love you too, honey. Thank you.
Can you tell Kocham Vas?
Can you say Kocham Vas?
I can try.
Kocham
Vas.
Thank
you. Kocham Vas.
Can you speak up, please?
How Scott is going to feel with them being together?
How's it going to feel?
Yes.
I still can't hear you. I'm so sorry.
How Scott is going to feel with them being together?
I understand now. Thank you. I think that he's a very supportive son, as I think my role has been to him, so I think that he'll be probably shocked at first, and then very accepting, I believe. Thank you.
Hi, I wanted to ask, do you have a scene from any season of Teen Wolf which made you the most emotional? Did you cry or something like this? I mean, the most emotional one.
There's a scene that happens in the last 10 episodes that was actually the most impactful and most emotional and most raw for both me and for Tyler. And it almost makes me sad to think about it, but it's really important But other than that scene that we haven't seen yet, back in season 5 when I had to pretend like he was dead and cry on the floor, that was intense. And then remember when we were all tied up underneath the Metatron? Right? That was a tough couple of days. It took 3 days to shoot that scene. And that was at the time real dirt and real ropes. And so we were like roped up for 3 hours. We couldn't use the bathroom. It was crazy. It was crazy.
You have lots of crying in the show, actually.
Yes. Jeff likes to put a lot of pressure and pain on me all the time. It's totally fine.
Next question, please.
My favorite season of Teen Wolf is the first season. I think it was really beautiful. We were in Atlanta. We were making the show. It was just us. You know, it was a little Romeo and Juliet with a little bit of werewolf in it. It was a beautiful, beautiful season. It was the first time we were all working together and becoming friends, and so that was really special. And I'm good friends with Melissa McBride, who plays Carol on The Walking Dead. And so I knew that she booked it, and I was really looking forward to watching the show the first season for her. And it was just an amazing experience to be booked on the show and be on it for as long as I was. That was just a, what we like to call a happy accident. But the first season also for The Walking Dead, I think, was really an important time for that show.
And when you received the role in The Walking Dead, did you immediately know that they would give you up, or you thought you go with them on the journey long ago?
So, you auditioned for a show maybe over and over again. And then one day, maybe you get the call that you book something, right?
Yeah.
So that's what happened with me for The Walking Dead. They called, they said, we have a role for you, but we can't tell you anything about it. Very secretive. Do you want to do it? And I was like, I'll serve coffee on the set to everyone. I would clean everybody's house. I would do anything to be on that show. So I get there, and you know, things go smoothly. So they have it back a couple times, and then sometimes you hear you're going to be there a long time. And then you get maybe a change of boss, maybe a change of the storyline. And that's what happened in season 4 when they made Karen and Tyrese a couple, and they needed to creatively raise his emotional stakes. So that's why Carol got the queen first.
Bummer.
I know that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for your question, honey.
Hi, my question is, do you like more Scott or Scott and Allison?
Ooh. Ooh. That's a tough one. I mean, as a mom, you just want to support your child. You know, I mean, that's how I thought about it going into it and acting. So I can't pick one. That's probably a better question for Tyler. Who do you like working with them?
Well,
they both work
though. Yeah, but when I was watching Teen Wolf and I saw this episode where all the friends went to Mexico.
They were the parents.
Yeah, what kind of mother are you?
I know. My friend just goes to Mexico without me apparently. But I would like to point out that on the show, if you really think about it, Mom and Paul has had more dates and more action than any of those other girls. Right? Seriously.
But how can you not know that she was in Mexico?
I work a lot in the hospital. If you watch the show,
yes.
I'm always working. Because nobody else works if you can know more in the hospital. I do
that. How many injured people do you have in this town?
Everyone. Nobody is safe in that town. I'm telling you what.
Okay, next one.
Green Bird!
Why? I'm gonna say why.
Well, Green Bird is a character that's only referenced to Otuno. It's just a funny thing. I really like Coach. I think Coach is a lot of fun, right? And Coach's styles together is a lot of fun. But Coach, to me, it brings a lot of levity to the episodes that he's in. You know, we can go dark and we can go deep on the show. He's always kind of messing things up, cursing somebody out. It's great.
He's a loose guy. Right?